This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book Westomars by Charles L. Fontenay. Westomars. Of all the planets, Peach liked Mars best. Peach was a salesman, and his territory was the inhabited planets and moons. There were things he liked about each one, even Earth, but he particularly enjoyed the gentle gravity of Mars, a gravity that made him feel as though he were flying when he walked in long, easy leaps, and yet didn't frighten him by letting him shoot halfway out to space. His stop at Mars in 2081 added an experience which Peach considered an extraordinary piece of luck. Having supper with Samlon Britt in Westomars was comparable to having tea with Shah Jahan in the Taj Mahal. The supper had been incomparable. Now the two of them sat in the dice room of the tower, warmed by a green and orange blaze in the huge fireplace, and smoked the sweet, strong, foot-long cigars that are produced only in the Hadriacum lowlands of Mars. Beyond the double-thick glass of the window wall, the sun was setting behind the fantastic dunes of the Aeolia Desert. Around them in the dim-lit room, the air was thick with cigar smoke, haunted by the aura of legend. The tales of the founding of Westomars were vague. Peach had heard the vast wealth that built it had been won on a single throw of the dice, that Britt had been driven to build it by the hatred of a woman he loved, that he had built it above the bones of a man who had stolen his wife, that it was a memorial to his wife. While he was here, Peach hoped to sift truth from fancy, for he was a man of romantic bent. Below them, the tower dropped down the side of the cliff to a clear dome on the now-shadowed lowland of Lacus Lucrinus. The dome enclosed most of the majestic building and its exotic gardens from the thin, oxygen-poor Martian air. It was a daring conception, nowhere duplicated, an airtight building that projected high above its plasticine dome. Peach inhaled a long, sweet draft of smoke and blessed the fact that his product was the latest in weather control units. Only for such a major purchase would Samlon Britt have invited him here. "You aren't married, Mr. Britt," said Peach when the conversation provided him with an opening. "Don't you get lonesome out here, hundreds of miles from the nearest city, with no one around but robots?" "I have many tapes and films, Mr. Peach," replied Britt, smiling. He was a short, slight man with close-cropped gray hair and round, guileless eyes. "I have my gardens, and the lowland of Lacus Lucrinus, and the desert." "Even so, I'm surprised you haven't found a woman to share all this beauty and wealth with you. I'm sure there are many of them who'd be willing." "No doubt," replied Britt dryly. "But I am a man of peculiar tastes. I enjoy my own thoughts, and generally I prefer my own viewpoint, unalloyed by the differing outlook of someone else. I find your company interesting for an evening, Mr. Peach, but few women could share this isolation without becoming bored, and consequently a nuisance." Then Peach told Britt of his theory, that behind the accomplishments of every successful man, somewhere, lies the influence of a woman. It might be that his mother babied him far into puberty, and he achieved things to prove his integrity as an individual. It might be that he reacted to an unhappy love affair by proving himself a better man than his mother.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.